एवं नित्यलीला प्रविष्टम विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर स्मार भक्ति वेदांत श्री त्रिविक्रम गोस्वामी महाराज अभय चरण कमलों में अनंत कोटि साष्टांग दंडवत ज्ञापन करता हूँ। तत्पश्चात नित्यलीला प्रविष्टम विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर स्मार भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी महाराज नित्यलीला प्रविष्टम विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर स्मार भक्ति वेदांत तीर्थ गोस्वामी महाराज एवं प्रभुजी चरण परिव्राजक महाराज एवं प्रभु चरण श्रीपाद माधव महाराज एवं उपस्थित समस्त वैष्णव वैष्णवबिंद मातृबिंद हरिकथा पिपासु शत्रुबिंद सभी के चरण कमलों में मेरा यथाजथ दंड प्रणाम स्वीकार हो। हम लोग शिष्य केशव जी गौरी मठ से
So we have
परिक्रमा करते करते
doing parikrama from Keshavaji Gauri Amma.
जवना के गंगा की तट होते हैं। अभी हम लोग त्रिगुणातीत
समाधि आश्रम
पहले हम लोग ने नित्य लीला प्रविष्टम
before in the beginning now we came
अष्टोत्तर सत्संग भक्ति वेदांत
we came here to the
मधुसूदन महाराज चरण कमल
we came to the feet of Shri Trivikram Goswami Maharaj
पुष्पांजलि अर्पित
and we are offering our पुष्पांजलि to him
जिन्होंने
मुझे महाराज
इस भक्ति मार्ग में और विशेष करके मठ वास करने के लिए मुझे हृदय में
he inspired my heart to stay in the temple in
वैराग्य जो
the path of bhakti
प्रजत्रिका
महाराज
कृपां बुद्धि जब परत का दुखे श्री मधुसूदन गोस्वामी प्रभु महाश्रय जिन्होंने
From beginning, Srila Madhusudana Goswami Maharaj, maybe I spoke wrong. So, Srila Madhusudana Goswami Maharaj inspired me to stay in the temple and to live in the temple and to come to the path of bhakti. He inspired me, Srila Madhusudana Goswami Maharaj. I didn't come from my house to live in the temple. No, I just came to here, Navadvipa, for the first time because I had heard from the lotus mouth of my mother about Srila Madhusudana Maharaj. Because my mother every year she used to come for Navadvipa Parikrama in Devananda Gauriya Math and everybody used to gather at the time there
and especially
my mother how she used to serve so much
Sorry,
I heard from the lotus mouth of my mother
about
also my uncle. So I heard from my mother from about the glories of my Vaishnava. So I wanted to have his darshan, like the darshan of my uncle. So I spent my life because I was in the college and in university school.
And then
I came here to Navadvipa Dham to have darshan. To see the Navadvipa Dham and to see my uncle. So I remember it was the month of Kartik that time. It was near the time of Kartik and Srila Madhusudana Maharaj, he gave so much love and affection to me. And he respect me so much, like he gave me so much respect
and
affection. I cannot even explain with any word how much he treated me. I forgot everything and I surrendered myself to his lotus, to his feet. And living in the temple, I served him. Maharaj, at that time his name was Krishna Kripa Brahmachari. Generally, he was sick. Many times he was sick. His body was not good, not well.
And
especially during the night, he used to take
khoi.
I don't know the translation. It's just like one kind of rice with some milk. It's just one kind of flakes of rice or something with some milk. He used to take this. for eating. Sometimes he used to take some roti, some chapati. So he used to endeavor whole day, doing hard work whole day. Salamat Sudana Maharaj.
And
that time this place was not here, only that garden. So he used to work here also in the garden. It's like a big garden of the temple. So he used to plant the trees, he used to do everything with his own hands. He used to do all the services, Salamat Sudana Maharaj. At that time, that temple had not so much money. So he. So we had to put some. We have to make the coal and like this and bring to the roof and to cook. At that time, Kamalapati Prabhu, now Srila Parivraj Maharaj was also there. So he has so much love and affection. He gave so much love and affection to all of us.
Maharaj,
I think that's
Maharaj.
So he had he used to bring me behind there where was his room, and he used to feed me so many fruits, so many foods. I remember Srila Parivrajak Maharaj gave so much love and affection to me. And under the guidance of Maharaj, I stayed. We used to serve under the guidance of Maharaj, especially at that time. They were building the Dharmashala in the temple. In Vivananda Gaudiamath, they were building the Dharmashala at that time. So some person, Sihaniya, gave some money.
Srila
Narayan Goswami Maharaj,
Gurudev, was building that
guest house. Actually, all the wealth of the Gaudiya Vedanta Samiti, if you see, actually was Srila Gurudeva. That he, because of the preaching, he collected all this money. And then he could refurbish, like renovate so many buildings and also create the school behind. He built so many things. Like guest house for the temple, so many things. We used to do so much service. Maharaj used to engage me in service. I remember that they were doing some work, and there was a big roof, and the roof like collapsed. Anyway, it was the desire of God, desire of Gurudeva. But we are saved. Maharaj was also there. So.
उस समय की बात होते कैसे हम लोग गुरुपादमा की सेवा करते थे
मठ में रह करके और सेवा आदि ये सब करते थे
और उस समय मठ के इतने कोई सामान नहीं था वो क्या बोलते हैं चावल के जो कण होता है जिसके बंगला में क्या बोलते हैं फूड बोलते हैं
देखो
फूड बोलते हैं ना बंगला में क्या बोलते हैं
हाथ देखो
So they used to give us something from the rice,
it's like some water from the rice, I don't know exactly the proper word, something from the rice, they used to mix with salt and eat that. Anyway, something from the rice with salt, I don't know the proper dish. Anyway, so he was the directly embodiment of service. So he was in white cloth. Srila Madhusudana Maharaj, I think he's talking. Srila Gurudeva, how many times told him, take sannyas, but he didn't take sannyas. In the end, in the year 2000, we were 12 or 14 persons that we took sannyas together. We took sannyas together.
And then, in the चलते रहे काल क्रम में अनेक बहुत कुछ परिवर्तन हो जाता है
बिकॉज़ ऑफ द टाइम सो मेनी थिंग्स चेंज
भूचाल भी आ जाता
है जस्ट लाइक समटाइम्स एन अर्थक्वेक कम्स गौड़िया
वेदांत समिति की एक बार भी भूचाल आ गया
वंस देयर वाज अ अर्थक्वेक इन गौड़िया वेदांत समिति
एंड
सो मेनी थिंग्स हैपेंड
बट स्टिल गुरुदेव उसके संभाल लिया सब बहुत पुराने पुराने की कथा याद आती है
गुरुदेव आल्सो टेक केयर
He's a very निष्ठा की एक बात मत बताओ
तो चलो बहुत ही निष्ठा
श्री
गुरुदेव सनातन गोस्वामी महाराज had so much love and affection for him
मैं साक्षात रूप में देखा
I saw that
जब महाराज जी आते थे मथुरा से आते थे
from Mathura
पर परम गुरु महाराज के प्रणाम करने के उपरांत
After the impranam to Param Guru Maharaj, he used to go to his room. Because the room of Srimad Bhaktisiddhanta Maharaj is just next to the Bhajana Kutir of Srila Bhakti Pragyana, Keshav Goswami Maharaj, behind. So he used to go to him and they used to sit down just like a friend. They used to talk so much. I think Srila Narayan and Srila Madhusudan, they're speaking about how the temple was everything. Gurudeva used to ask him, to Srimati Maharaj, about everyone, how is everyone, whatever Maharaj, sorry, he used to take care of everything, whatever everyone was doing and everything. So there are three pillars of Gurudeva Samhita. Srimati Lista Srimati Srimati Maharaj, Srimati Srimati Maharaj, and Trivikram Goswami
Maharaj.
When they were there, actually, how the Gurudeva Samhita used to run when they were there. How the Brahmacharis used to do so much service in this time of Parikrama. It was an amazing thing, amazing. I'm remembering something amazing that happened that one day. In the time of Parikrama, just now it starts in the month of Jet, it's very hot, strong rays of the sun. So we were going to Mamgachi one place, and that year they didn't give me prasada there. Under the scorched rays of the sun, we came back from Mamgachi. It was 2 p.m. The road was like burning, the road burned, so
anyway,
the Brahmacharis, they sat down like to take a bit of rest, but and the pilgrims, they were sitting under the sun. Yeah, because at that time there was not a tent everywhere, could not, so there was no shade everywhere, like, so the people were sitting under the rays of the sun, scorched rays of the sun. So the devotees, they were putting the plate on their heads to protect from the sun. But the Brahmacharis, they hadn't started to distribute the prasada yet. And my chachaji, my uncle, Srimad Sudha Maharaj, so my uncle went to Srila Gurudev Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj and said, no Brahmacharya is doing any seva, Brahmacharya is not doing any seva. Oh no, sorry, first Srila Matsudana went to Srila Vamana Maharaj. Vamana Maharaj told, go to my garden. Then Srila Narayana Goswami, so he went to Srila Narayana Goswami. I remember Shubhananda Brahmachari, Satita Maharaj. So he just came and told us, Maharaj Gurudev. At that time he used to call Srila Narayana Goswami as Maharaj, not Gurudev. So he used to call him Maharaj. So he told, Maharaj is coming. He just said like this, Maharaj is coming. So he, when he thought like this, all the Brahmacharis, wherever they are sitting taking rest, they start running. I saw that 2-4 Brahmacharis, no, there was a big mountain of rice. The 2-4 Brahmacharis, they fell inside, they jumped inside the mountain of rice.
Maharaj,
he always, his hands are moving and his feet are also moving. Like he means Srila Narayana Goswami Maharaj would always slap and kick those who are doing like chastising and giving discipline. So everybody was running, but Maharaj was so also giving so much love and affection. Maharaj used to speak so well that in such a beautiful way that he used to make our throats choked. Maharaj told, I know that you're going for 4 months, you're going from village to village to bring donation from Mahaprabhu for the service of Mahaprabhu. So there's only 2-3 more days. So just distribute this prasada for the devotees who came. So Maharaj, you speak like this, such a beautiful words, such beautiful sounds. Just like in the summertime, you like, what is the best thing you like? In the summertime, you love fresh wind to blow on you. Then your heart, your body will be so happy and refreshed, isn't it? So in the same way, Srila Gurudeva, these beautiful, sweet words from the mouth of Srila Gurudeva used to make everyone's heart melt, and all the Brahmacharis were serving because Gurudeva told them to. So Gurudev used to chastise, and in the same moment he used to also give so much love and affection. So he was always lapping and kicking. And also if his danda was also beating us, Srila Madhava Maharaj, he also is remembering us. So in the time of Tulasi Parikrama, those were old, no, we're always near Maharaj. In the time of Tulasi Parikrama in Devananda Gaudiya Math, so many pilgrims and some not so many and so many people in small place, so we're near Maharaj, but so many people pushing and pulling, so we fell on Maharaj. Used to follow Maharaj, Shlanarayan Maharaj. So Shlanarayan Maharaj, he's talking about Shlanarayan Maharaj, used to beat us with the danda. Used to beat us, not the pilgrims, but used to beat us, the Matavasis were near him. Not the pilgrims was putting
Maharaj.
So, I just want to tell something about Satyavikram Maharaj.
Satyavikram Maharaj.
Externally he was very strict and hard, but his heart was so soft, just like a coconut. A coconut externally is very hard, you know, a coconut is very hard from outside, but inside the coconut there is so much water.
Malai,
that pulp, so beautiful and soft. In the same way, Satyavikram Maharaj, he was externally rude and like hard, words harsh. Only this, our Maharaj, Puri Maharaj, could his name at that time was Haridas. Only he could stay Satyavikram Maharaj, because he used to chastise so much the Brahmacharis. There was one Prabhu who had a big head, Aniruddha Prabhu. So remember many things about Satyavikram Maharaj, because he used to insult, like, to swear like the Brahmacharis, like blaspheme, like insult. So he was married before, and then Satyavikram Maharaj, and the wife came and said, if you stay here, I'll kill myself. And then Satyavikram Maharaj said, look, before you kill yourself, don't worry, I'll put kerosene on you, and I will myself, I will lit the fire with the matches, and I'll burn you alive. So our Puri Maharaj, he stayed with him, especially Uma Didi. She had so much association with him. I didn't get so much association, but they got more. So how three of them, they used to serve so much, and under their guidance, all the Brahmachari sannyasis used to serve under their guidance. Other sannyasis will speak. So here I'll stop my speech. May Maharaj be merciful to me, especially Srimad Sudhir Goswami Maharaj. His love and affection, his, he took so much care of me, and that they may continue.
Apnara Maharaj Mukti ke sunlen, Param Pujya Shri Satyavikram Goswami Maharaj.